I'm Brian Russell, and I want to share a journaling practice that I use that really helps me to focus and concentrate and progressively makes life a little better each day. And this is critically important for the times that we face. We're all feeling significant disruption in our lives. If you're a business owner, you're wondering how you're going to deliver maximum value to your customers when people aren't as able to be in as much proximity. If you're a pastor, you're struggling with thinking like, how do I make ministry virtual in some cases? But what these are times when we can't neglect our own self-leadership. And I found one of the most powerful tools to be essentially a 5-minute journaling practice that I do. I call it thinking time. And it's a little bit in the morning and even a little bit less in the evening. So this will take 5 minutes probably for the whole day. If you go a real deep dive, it's no more than 10 minutes, but most days it's gonna be 5 minutes or even less. And in the morning, as you prime yourself to get ready for your day, I'd recommend doing this fairly soon after you wake up and before you begin your regular work. Take a few minutes and write down on a piece of paper. It's really important to write. What am I grateful for? Now, I always try to write 5 things. Be as specific as you can and try to feel what it is that you're grateful for. So if you want to make something mundane, like I'm grateful for a cup of coffee, try to write specifically how you're grateful for that, your family, grateful for the sunshine, but find things to be grateful for. This is critically important during difficult times because gratitude primes us for abundance. After I do that, then I do the more difficult task, which is then I try to explore for a couple of minutes, you know, what's holding me back today? What is bothering me? What obstacles am I facing? And a lot of those obstacles are going to be within. Maybe you're noticing yourself to be more anxious, and try to get underneath. Notice your feelings, but write down what's bothering you and be as specific as you can. Because getting that out on paper, again, is a way of releasing yourself so then you can take on the day. And then after you've worked through that, then write down what must I accomplish today to make it a great one. Again, we're not looking for a task list, but write down what are the important things. What are some actions that you can do to take action on the very things that are bothering you? Prioritize that and move forward, and you can and make that the focus of your day. So that's the morning piece. Again, this primes you. Gratitude, recognizing both what's actually bothering you on the inside and also what obstacles you're facing, and then creating an action plan for the day. Now, at the end of the day, you want to make sure that you get some closure. So it's important, good or bad, to write down at night. I do this a little bit before I go to bed, but when look back at your day and close it down and say, what 3 things, at least 3 things that went really well, or 3 things that I learned. And so even on a tough day, something went well, and you want to harvest the good things in your mind because that then gives you a sense of satisfaction. Dan Sullivan talks about putting yourself on a winning streak by doing this, by focusing on what went right. Again, that primes you to get a good night's sleep and to be ready for the next day. And then, you know, the last thing, you know, before you go to rest, like, what do I need to do tomorrow? And begin to think about some things that I'm going to take action on tomorrow. And that lets you shut the day down essentially with a sense of gratitude because you're remembering what went well. You sleep, you wake up the next day, and you repeat it. Now, again, I would suggest doing this long term. I've been doing pretty close to this exact model for almost 10 years now, and it's been life changing for what I've been able to accomplish and the way that I even feel about my accomplishments. But during a time such as this, it's a great time to start because you need thinking time. You're going to have plenty of ways to worry. This allows you to take action despite obstacles, limitations, and even bad feelings and anxiety that you feel on the inside. I'm Brian Russell. If you have any questions, I'd love to have a conversation with you or hear from you in the comments.